Jaguars, Bills, Ryan Fitzpatrick, 4 touchdown passes away from passing Jack Kemp for 3rd most in franchise history. Yeah, but could he legislate like Kemp? We'll see. First quarter, Bills ball. Fitzpatrick looking for TJ Graham over the middle. And Graham gets down to the 1-yard line. Almost Jack Kemp. Leads to a 1-yard Fitzpatrick touchdown run. Bills up 7-0. Second quarter, Bills ball still leading 7-0. Fitzpatrick looking for Stevie Johnson. Instead, finds Paul Besluzny. He returns at 5 yards to the Bills 32 that would lead to a Josh Scobie field goal. Jaguars trail by the score of 7-3. 2 Jaguars possessions later, still trailing 7-3. Second and goal from the Bills 1. Chad Henne runs into the end zone. Touchdown, Chad Henne on the play action. Jacksonville takes the lead 10-7 in a driving rainstorm. Ensuing Bills drive trying to answer. Fitzpatrick looking over the middle. Scott Chandler got it for the 11-yard touchdown. Bills take a 14-10 lead. So now it's the Jaguars' turn. First and 10 from their own 20. Chad Henne, got to remember the football, Chad. Stripped and recovered by Mario Williams at the Jaguars' 14. Would lead to a Ryan Lindell 29-yard field goal. Bills up 17-10 at halftime. Third quarter now. Bills ball leading 17-10. Fitzpatrick looking for Stevie Johnson on the sideline. Johnson's got it for a 13-yard touchdown. See, 13-13. Stevie Johnson hasn't been in the end zone in a while, but still, he remembers how to dance. 24-10, Bills lead. Fourth quarter now, Bills ball. Where is C.J. Spiller? Why is he not in this highlight? Well, you'll see just right now. Fred Jackson had a 100-yard day, and here's C.J. Spiller. Streaks down the sideline. 44 yards later, he is in the end zone. Bills lead it 34-10. They go on to win it by the final of 34-18. Cecil Shorts had a touchdown before leaving the game with an injury.